My first group ride in 5 years. I guess I'd better get going. Gotta try to catch up with them. It's a beautiful Sunday morning, about 17 degrees at Celsius, and, well, I'll be honest, I've only got 100 kilometers under my belt so far this year. Finally got the clutch master and slave cylinders rebuilt. Videos on that will be coming up later, but I just thought I'd get a video out on me going out and having, well, participating in a group ride, which is not something I usually do. I think most motorcyclists would agree that when you've had a bit of a layoff, or if you're getting on a bike that's new to you, you probably need at least 1,000 kilometers under your belt before you start feeling confident about your abilities again, and also feel that you know the bike, how it handles, where the controls are. It's a bit of a drill every single spring, only this year it's now fall.
Now, the last group ride I did was in Huntsville, but that was with a bunch of I think well-experienced riders, mostly ST riders, ST1300s, 1100s, good smattering of other large displacement bikes. The time before that, cripes, it's got to be 2016, I think, is when we did the ride taking the steel to the Gander. That was a lot of bikes in the end, and made me nervous a few times, but that's all right. So this should be a smaller group ride, I think. And this group ride is a ride for the fallen. So it was supposed to be yesterday on 9/11 memory day.
There's more bikes than I was expecting. I think the count was 42 leaving Twin Peaks Motorsports. 42 is not a bad turnout for Corner Brook. You're going to hear the difference between my in-studio voiceovers and the mic on the helmet. I wish I could get them quite even. We're just about right on time to get started. I'm surprised at just the diversity of motorcycles here. Pretty well all manufacturers and all styles of bike, which is great. I kind of like that. The group gets broken up a bit by by traffic lights. But once we get out on the highway, within about 15 minutes, we're pretty well grouped back up. But first we gotta get down through the Humber Valley. It's almost exactly 49 years since I got my motorcycle license. Maybe all the accumulative time makes it so much easier to adapt each year to getting back on the bike. But it feels right. It feels very right.
Okay, so we're not stopping here. I think we're stopping the jack ladder, which means I can change batteries then. I don't even know if my camera's still rolling. I can't wait to see it. Looks like I might see numbers. Here's bikes up on top of the bridge.
And I'm right. The camera dies just before we get to the jack ladder. Jack ladder is a gas bar and restaurant. A lot of people will stop there. A few people took advantage to top up their gas tanks. I used the time to change my helmet cam battery and get a few other cameras on the roll just so I can play a little bit. And then we're gonna get back on the road, it seems. Just a few minutes down the road, and we enter Wiltondale. And Wiltondale is the start of Gros Morne National Park. Now we're going to take a left and go down to Trout River on the south side of the park. And this is a road that a lot of traveling motorcyclists seem to miss. It's actually one of the nicest rides in the park, and the park is all good riding. I sometimes think I should just do 45 minutes of straight riding through Gros Morne with some good music in the background and no voiceovers. But that's not today's video.
I don't like this corner.
This road between the tablelands to the left and green gardens to the right is always one of my favorite stretches of highway. The helmet cam dies just before the descent into Trout River. Good thing I've got a couple of other cameras running. This is our destination point, the Blue Whale Cafe and gas bar. So again, some people take advantage of being able to top up. Others take advantage of getting some fries, burgers, whatever. The other good restaurant in town is the Seaside Restaurant, which is on the waterfront. We seem to be losing a few people at almost every stop. A few people do leave a little bit early. But I decide I really want to get out in front of the group and get a chance to video the whole group or what's left of it going by. So I take off a few minutes before everyone else is ready to leave. Right about here, I had the trailer come off the bike 2 years ago. But that's a whole other video. You'll have to go back and look for that. Before actually getting on the road and trying to catch up, I kind of neglected to have a pit stop at the Blue Whale Cafe, so figure I better have a real pit stop here. And that's what it is. It's a pit. Now that wouldn't be so bad, but it's closed due to COVID. I might not be able to go in, but at least I can go behind.
Okay, I'm gonna take a while to catch up to those guys. I know that. Yep, I don't like this.
I might be overplaying this a little bit, but the action cam does flatten out this road a lot more than it actually is. It's quite steep, and this turn at the bottom, including a stop sign, it's kind of nasty. I helped pick up a Harley here once, and it always makes me a little uneasy.
Nope, I just don't like that.
Quite often, I'll actually do a little runabout Woody Point, because it's a nice little town. But today, I just do a quick turnabout and head back. Yep, I gotta try to catch up with those guys. I'm having a really good run. It's a nice excuse to try to have to catch up to the group. So at Wiltondale, get back on the more main highway, and things get a little bit more serious just up the road. No, you get this gut feeling as soon as you see a few things pulled over, and I knew it had to be a motorcycle. A motorcyclist missed the turn and went down into the ditch and almost over a cliff. Lots of people here to help, including someone from our group who I'm pretty sure has got EMS training.
Here comes the ambulance. Good.
It's a little ironic to be out raising a little bit of money for Wounded Warriors Canada. And of course, thinking about first responders, and yeah, there we go. First responders, keeping us safe, trying to keep us alive. I finally catch up to everyone. We get a chance to have a little bit of a chat before pretty well all heading our own ways. Yes, the motorcyclist, pretty badly beat up. Not life-threatening, but going to be a long recovery. A relatively new rider on a brand new motorcycle. So definitely a bike that they weren't used to. And I'm not going to criticize anyone's riding skills, but it does bring into mind the fact that, yeah, I'm a little rusty. I need to get a few more kilometers under my belt before I'm going to feel that I really am back in the game. So I'm almost home. Just want everyone to stay safe out there. We've got a lot more miles for each of us to travel. A lot more miles. It was good to get out with a group today. Enjoyed myself. And have just had a good time riding. So, thank you all for watching. Stay safe, and we'll see you again soon with a new video.